Let's begin our coverage with CNN's Bryn Gingras. She is live in North Brunswick, New Jersey, at the deadly shooting at that federal judge's home. What have you learned at this hour, Bryn?
Yeah, Allison, I mean, this is a neighborhood in disbelief. We just talked to a neighbor who said that Esther Salas and her husband, Mark, were wonderful people. Their son, Daniel, just 20 years old, also just a wonderful man who wanted to be a lawyer just like his parents. Now, what we're learning from investigators here, what happened at this home behind me, you can see the crime scene tape still up. From sources, we're learning that a gunman came to the door of this home, the door answered by the judge's son, again, 20-year-old Daniel, his father not far behind men, that gunman wearing a FedEx uniform. It's unclear if it was a disguise or actually a FedEx employee, but opened fire, killing the 20-year-old and injuring the judge's husband, who's now at the hospital. We hear that the judge was home at the time, but unharmed. So a lot of questions here. Of course, motive being the major one. Why did this happen? What are the reasonings? Investigators, including the FBI, U.S. Marshals, looking into that as we speak. We know that, as you guys said, the judge, Esther Salas, she has presided over some really high-profile cases, including the fraud case and sentencing of the Real Housewives, Teresa and Joe Giuducci, a couple of years ago. Also, she was involved with the sentencing of a very notorious gang member in Newark. And most recently, she was handed the case that involved Deutsche Bank and its handling of high-risk clients, including Jeffrey Epstein. So that was a class-action suit with Deutsche Bank. So there are a number of things that investigators looking into, and again, as I mentioned, her husband as well, a criminal defense attorney. So a lot here that investigators are sifting through, and it's a massive investigation. Neighbors telling us that this son was really the heart of this family. She recalled a story when he delivered chicken soup through the snow a couple doors down, just to make sure that the neighbors were well taken care of during a massive snowstorm. Loved playing basketball and baseball with his father. It's just a heartbreaking story, and so many questions still need to be answered this morning.
Indeed, indeed. All right, Bryn Gingras in New Brunswick or North Brunswick, thanks very much for being with us. Joining us now, CNN law enforcement analyst Jonathan Wackrow. He's a former Secret Service agent in the Obama White House. Jonathan, thanks so much for being with us. Look, as we said, this judge was presiding over several high-profile cases. The husband, also a criminal defense attorney, which raises questions. How are federal agents now going about investigating this case?
Well, thanks, John. Listen, this is a very complicated case, but let me just be clear. This was not a crime of opportunity. This was a premeditated attack. So when we look at, you know, from law enforcement's point of view, they're looking at the attack elements. They're looking at things like the cover, the recognition and accessibility. What does that mean? The cover that was used, this attacker used the cover of a FedEx delivery person to get close to the house. And think about how brazen this attack was. You could have attacked the judge or her husband or the son at any location. This attacker went right to the front door. They limited their recognition by the potential victim by utilizing the cover. So being able to get right to that front door, have the front door open, and then launch this brutal attack. And then the accessibility, the ease of entering into the property and getting out to the attack location. The fact that this was done in broad daylight, to me, is an indicator that the attacker had no fear of being caught. So right now, this is the challenge for law enforcement. What is the motive? We know the intent was to kill, but what is the motive of this attack?
And Jonathan, if the intent is to kill, then is it common in these horrible cases for the shooter to leave after killing the wrong person? In other words, the idea, people are looking at whether or not this federal judge, Esther Salas, was the target. But she wasn't shot. Her husband was, and her son was killed. What does that tell us?
Well, listen, I think this is the challenge right now. I know everyone's keying in on the federal judge, but we have two very prominent figures that were living in this house at the same time. And there are various potential motivating grievances for both of them. I know just in the previous reporting, we highlighted some of the cases that the federal judge was addressing. But there's a lot of threat vectors that could come from the husband as well. As a prominent criminal defense attorney, there are a lot of people that could have a grievance towards him as to things that he may or may not have done to defend his clients. So this is where law enforcement has a significant job ahead of them to look at both the husband and the wife separately in terms of threats against them. Who had the means, opportunity, and intent to cause harm? That's the underlying factors that they're looking for both of them. And, you know, this is, we're really at the infancy of this investigation. And there'll definitely be more to come very quickly.
In terms of the federal judge, one of the cases she was assigned to cover was involving Deutsche Bank and possible fraud on the handling of investments, including those of Jeffrey Epstein, which I know will catch everyone's attention and eyebrows here. How do investigators go about looking at past cases of the judge?
Well, listen, they have to look at everything. Obviously, that's a very prominent thing right now. It's just put on the docket. But they have to go back. Again, we don't know where this grievance came from. We don't know what the motivation was. This could be a case from 5-6 years ago. So what law enforcement has to do right now is gather all the facts that they have. They have to look at both the husband and the wife. They have to look at the entire digital domain. Who were they talking to? Did they receive any types of threats? Did their staff receive any types of threats? A lot of times, the individuals may not know that there were a lot of troubling telephone calls coming into an office location or hate mail or anything like that. So again, law enforcement is going through. They're going to put out a wide net to collect as much evidence as possible, as much information as possible, to then start narrowing down the potential motivating factors for this attack.
Jonathan Wackerall, thank you very much for all of the expertise in law enforcement. We appreciate it.
Thank you.